going to have the losers match. Just to recap the brackets a little bit, we did see Life Coach take the first seed in his group, but the first players to lose was Th3rat and Silentstorm. They lost their opening games in this group, and they're going to have to face each other for a chance at the second seed if they do defeat Phonetap. Do you guys know much about Th3rat and Silentstorm?
I don't know much about Th3rat except for, like everyone's mentioned, he plays Patron a lot. But Silentstorm won last season. He's playing Druid, one of his special classes, and he's been just doing great in everything. He hasn't been in that many events, but everything he's in, he always performs amazingly well. Like his first breakout performance was the Prismata Cup, I believe, where he got to the finals and he's playing against Kalenta with another version of Demon deck, not the one he brought at ESL, but another one. So yeah, he was my pick to win last time, and he did. And I think he'll do great this time as well.
Hopefully. Now, Th3rat has been the self-proclaimed best Grim Patron player in the world. Now, what do you know about this double O's? Like, how well can you play this deck?
Me, personally, I can't play it that well. But Th3rat is, like you said, very, very vocal about how good he is at the deck. He'll be over here in the Players' Lounge constantly commentating on everyone else's play as they play with the Grim Patron deck. I know him through the sort of online tournaments that I play. That's kind of where he got his fame at first. Mm-hmm. And then his ability learning and teaching Patron to other players is kind of where he has grown fame in the scene as a whole.
Now, we didn't get a chance to see him play yet, but from the notes that we have from the games that were played off-stream against Life Coach, apparently he played Warlock 3 times and lost 3 times. So he is yet to break in the tournament with the Grim Patron Warrior, and I hope that's not the case in the match coming up against Silentstorm. Yeah, good stuff. You have much experience with Silentstorm, Double O's?
No, not really. I think I've played one best of five with him, and he wrecked me. Which, you know, a guy who's as experienced as he is in these kind of areas, but is also as quiet as he is, just has the ability to perform better than some, the people who are constantly showcased. I think that's one of the best weapons he has is his quietness, and he doesn't stream all the time, and he doesn't show what he does. You know, he has his own special, style.
He doesn't stream, but he does always have the spectate on his friends list, so I'm always spectating him, and I know a lot of other people always are, because he's always one of the few people. Usually when people get high ranked, maybe they get a little paranoid about the spectate, and usually I go down to my friends list, and I look at the lowest number with the spectate icon, and it's always Silentstorm, so I just click there, watch.
Well, we see cool the classes up there. We see both players with Warrior, both players with Warlock, both players opening with Warlock, Th3rat coming in with the Hunter, and Silentstorm coming in with the Druid, as their differences. Now, we mentioned throughout the tournament that Warrior and Hunter are probably going to be the dominant classes, so that seems like it may favor Th3rat's setup, but we'll have to see how it plays out here. So Th3rat, I'm pretty surprised that he is opening up with Warlock after losing with it 3 times against Life Coach. What's good about this deck?
Oh, I'm not even sure what kind of Warlock is. Is it Handlock? Is it Demon Lock?
If I know his style, it's going to be some form of mid-range or aggro.
Your soul shall suffer.
Okay, so it's a Demon Lock. And,
I mean, that's just his style. He's aggressive, and he wants people to know it.
Actually, this is a Zoo hand.
Yeah, Demon
it?
Zoo. Yeah, the Demon Lock, there's no such thing as Demon Lock, although it is coming back, the late-game Demon Lock. So Demon Lock now is pretty much just this with a Mal'Ganis, maybe a Sea Giant.
Okay.
Void Callers, maybe 2 Void Terror, maybe just 1, something like that. Yeah. It's not that great against Handlock.
Yeah, Handlock does set up those Molten Giants with the taunts, and then the Zoo or whatever demon or whatever type of Warlock this might be generally can't deal with it.
Yeah, you can't classify this deck really as mid-range, but it's just a slower aggro, and those kind of decks are really weak against a good Handlock draw.
Well, that's not a particularly good Handlock draw. It's okay, but not playing anything until a Twilight Drake is going to be pretty painful.
Yeah, and I think he favors 1 Dark Iron, 1 Implosion, rather than the 2 Implosion that most people do. And he might not even, if I see the Dark Iron, he might not even play Void Terrors.
Yeah.
I mean, Void Callers.
Dark Iron is something I haven't seen in a while in this kind of list, so it might just be a super aggressive Zoo type.
I like the point here, just because it's a perfect curve.
Yeah.
It's a pretty weak turn too, but it's not the worst against Handlock, who's going to try to clear your board.
You know exactly what you're doing with this hand when you're the rat, so yeah. It's a good play.
Yeah, but like you said, the Dark Iron might suggest it's more aggressive.
Wow.
Oh, and he gets the perfect day job. The Dark Iron might suggest more aggressive things like Dark Bomb, which would be great against Silentstorm's Handlock here.
Absolutely.
Rag is not going to do much.
Now, so far that whole board dies to Hellfire. I wonder how much more you play into it.
I mean, the egg helps with that a lot.
It does. But if you play the Imp Gang boss, it's not the worst either. Like, that doesn't die to Hellfire. You get another Imp. You have 3 power on the board instead of 4.
I think you would...
Okay, I think that just totally puts it one-sided on the egg now.
That's a pretty good curve he's had so far all game.
Yeah, the Leprechaun might, like I said, suggest the Dark Bomb.
Yeah, when you really think about it, for how his deck is laid out and planned to beat the Handlock, this is as good as a curve as it gets, possibly.
Well, if you get him to 12, that's Molten Giant Sun Fury range, which sucks.
I don't know, you got the Dark Iron right there.
I kind of like just getting him to 14. Just give him a Molten Giant, and if he wants to play, he loses his turn. And I mean, he's probably playing something big on 4 anyway, so I like the 14. A 12 can be disastrous, I
think. I think 14 is probably the correct way. It's just looking at the rat's hand, because it's not like he has double Soulfire like how it used to be, you know, when the card existed.
And I don't really like this either. I like to put this near the doggy just in case you don't want a Dark Iron next turn.
I mean, you can attack first with the Imp and then put the Egg in. I'm a little curious about that as well.
And no Leprechaun.
Okay, so he holds back on the 2 damage, like you mentioned.
Well, that sucks if you're Silentstorm. Oh god.
Yeah.
Is that it? Oh, okay. Not quite,
but... You know, there's definitely ways Silentstorm can crawl back into this game with the Molten, Double Belcher, Al, Sun Fury. I mean...
He just has no heal right now.
No, that's all he needs, and then he can completely stabilize and turn a game.
Well, here you just make the play based on what you think is in the deck. Like, if you have a Power Overwhelming, I think you just go for it.
Yeah, but do you keep the egg as an egg, or do you pop the egg?
You keep the egg as an egg and play a Leper Gnome. If you get a Power Overwhelming from the tap, I think you basically just win.
Okay.
I wonder.
It's like, I think that's really what he's debating, is to tap or not. And it goes right into the Dark Iron, it looks like.
Okay.
I mean,
he's gonna have the egg and the dark iron that are out of Hellfire range.
That was a big misplay.
Yeah.
Because he was able to kill the Drake by attacking.
Yeah, he did
the
in the wrong order.
First,
this just
which I believe is how he set up the game as a whole.
Oh, look at that!
And that's how you get punished. I mean,
absolutely wrecked is more like it. I think here you'd,
so you'd do something
if you
want
for sure, but I think you'd do Owl
the Voidwalker
and kill the doggy. I think that removes more damage off the board.
Absolutely.
Yeah, because he can trade the, he can get multiple dog procs. Maybe the Owl should have been next to the Sunfury. I guess it doesn't really matter though with the Twilight Drake.
That's like, oh. Wrap this again. Are you kidding me?
I mean, Power
Overwhelming. Can't I get a win with this deck?
Power Overwhelming would have cleared those. He has a lot of power on board. It's really about how the rat wants to position for a lethal as soon as possible.
He can push for 1 damage.
Yeah. That's a lot.
So many possibilities.
Ah, really? Well, they can't do more than that.
No. That's probably his best play. I'm curious if he does have things like Dark Bomb. That will be really important coming up. You know, I wonder if he wants... what he wants to do that way.
Okay, so it looks like he wants to end the turn with a 5-5 taunt. Which seems alright.
Yeah, he wants to get the Leper Gnome in for sure and then Doomguard on the kill turn. If that's even possible. So next turn you can Power Realm and Doomguard, best case scenario.
Yeah, that's... getting the Leper Gnomes out is really important because it just represents damage that doesn't have to go through time. And you don't want the Doomguard to get rid of that, obviously.
If he had played the Leper Gnome earlier, wouldn't he have swung with it twice and won?
Yeah, I think... I don't know if you can play that way. Wow, that's another draw.
Oh, look at that. Let's heal up a little bit.
Basically, when you're Silent Storm in this position as a handlock, when you have this many options...
I think I like Siphon Soul better, actually.
Yeah, I think Siphon Soul is a better play, but like, he's just sitting here with even more options going forward. It's going to be really hard for him to lose unless the Rat can draw into a Dark Bomb if that's in this deck. It's those kind of things.
Yeah, it's some like crazy owl turn that he'd need to win here. And that just seems fairly unlikely.
Put this apple on your head!
Okay.
It's pretty good. I mean, looking back on how this game progressed, it's not even like... I mean, it's not even like that misplay with the popping the egg really mattered at all, because that he needed that damage afterwards, so
yeah,
it's kind of odd that there's another one. I mean,
yeah, really the one thing, like, you're right, it's hard to classify anything as a misplay at this stage.
No, I think that actually ended up being a good thing for him, even though it wasn't the right play.
Right.
It's funny how that worked out, but every draw Silentstorm has had is so good in all these situations.
I think the one thing you really could have done to maybe win is to just play that Leper Gnome.
Yeah. I think that 2 damage that gets through taunt is pretty key.
No, he would have gotten attack in with it. It would have been 4 damage. And maybe you could have snuck in like 2 extra in between there.
I love how sad Soundstorm was when he had no options but the Twilight Dragon and thought he was dead. He threw it out there.
Yeah.
And then he got perfect draws.
Every draw you need in that matchup.
Yeah, Handlock is one of those classes that some of the cards are just so overwhelmingly powerful that even in the most hopeless situations, you can get just ridiculous draws and swing a game completely in your direction. And we saw exactly that. And the Rat is 4-0 with this Warlock deck. We haven't seen this Warlock. Actually, I think this is the first aggressive Warlock deck we've seen.
Yeah.
0-4.
I think Kalino was running something similar to this, wasn't he?
Was he?
Crazy. Maybe I'm crazy. But yeah, we really haven't seen any of this. It's been all Handlock. And that's because right now, if you're going to be a control player, the best control deck is Handlock.
And it does well against Warriors in general. Well-ish.
It's the deck that I did well with today. It went 3-0.
Oh, here we go.
Okay, so I believe Silentstorm's Warrior is Control Warrior, correct? Not a Patron.
We'll have to see.
And I'm guessing it's going to have Double Brawl in Harrison. So he's going to have a good chance.
You think Double Brawl is standard?
I think so. If you go into a tournament expecting Handlock and Patron, and you're going to play Control Warrior, then you have to bring Double Brawl. You don't. It doesn't really.
Yeah, when you put it that way, I think you're absolutely right.
Yeah, but it's still not. Some people are saying it's a counter, but I think Patron still has a great chance. If Patron can do something like, if they could just put the Death Spite on, hit you, and then Grim Patron on 5, sometimes you just lose to that if they have an Inner Rage.
All I know is, being the best Grim Patron Warrior player in the world, I'm about to learn something.
Yeah. I hope I'm about to learn something.
Yeah.
If he says he's this good. You know, every one of these Patron pros, and there's a handful of them that are just as confident in their ability as the Rat is, says that there is not a single bad matchup
that
in
Nefarian?
The game. That
Nefarian doesn't necessarily mean Dragon Warrior. It could just be, it's a great card. I love it a lot. And the Harrison usually means it's not Dragon Warrior, because you don't really have room for those Corruptors on 5, because you want to play the Belchers. Alright, so Soundstorm should have, if he's playing 2 Brawls, it's more likely that he gets the Brawls in time than the Rat gets the crazy Death Spite, Grim Patron, Inner Rage on 5.
Mm-hmm. That's 3 cards of cycle that he has in his hand right now, at the least.
Dropping the Frothing is kind of strange to me. Like, what else can you play on 3? Acolyte?
I think he just wants to save it for later, Double Frothing OTK.
Oh, there's Acolyte.
It's a pretty good one.
I don't know how good Acolyte is when it runs up against another Acolyte. Like, if both players draw the same, doesn't the Control Warrior win?
With that Emperor in hand, I think the Rat wants them both to draw.
I see.
The Rat would play Cold Light with that Emperor in his hand, for example.
Yeah.
Cold Light, new meta.
It's a fun card.
That's a great card.
It's one of those cards that just never completely leaves.
It leaves an impact on any game, that's for sure.
Yeah. Whoa.
Vanilla armor out.
That's how we do it.
Yeah. That's, I mean...
I've learned.
Yeah, that's the best patron player in the world, right there.
Let the pain speak to me.
I like this. He has the Cruel to shut down the... kind of shut down the second Acolyte, or he has the...
The funny thing is, if you're playing on ladder, and the warrior does this against you, you know immediately what warrior it is. Yeah. In the tournament setting, it's a much more powerful game play because you already know exactly what warrior it is.
I mean, if you're playing ladder right now, you're playing as patron warrior for the most part anyways. Mm. I mean, let's be real. But I mean, Hyped, are you playing a lot of that? Like, how much experience do you have?
Yeah, there's a decent amount of control. They always like pop up every a week, and then they disappear for a week and stuff like that. And yeah, if I'm playing Rogue, for example, like that Acolyte is actually a huge deal because like I want to prevent that free Acolyte draw. I want to play like a naked SI7 against a Grim Patron Warrior every time to prevent the Acolyte. But if it's a Control Warrior and just gets Fire Raid, you really don't want to do that. You need the SI7 Battle Cry, for example.
Seems awful.
What I mean, now?
Nothing in his hand does anything. It's purely reactive at this point.
Yeah.
I must choose.
This is great for Soundstorm.
No loot hoarders, none of those things that the Rat wants at the
same time. Is he baiting the Harrison, or?
That was an armor up.
Yeah.
Wow.
I don't get it. When do you armor up and when don't you armor up?
Yeah, I don't know why you'd armor up now if that was your strategy.
Especially
I think
now
he
that
figures
you
anything that's
going to
hit him at this point
range.
Is going to do more than 2 damage. Yeah. Now that the Acolyte's gone.
Yeah.
Turn is gone.
Except he's actually going to play exactly Acolyte.
Yeah. Is he going to swing?
I don't think so.
He has a turn 5 anyways with Belcher, so he's probably not going to swing. He has the second Acolyte anyways to do the draw. Yeah.
This is so funny. Both players drawn both Acolytes.
There's so much draw.
Let the pain speak to me.
Yeah, now he said he armored up. He would have been the perfect 29.
Riftar, Ogre!
Probably go for the execute on the Acolyte there.
You think so?
I think so.
It's a hard play to make, but
because
like,
play
it's like you don't need the Belcher down this
still
turn.
Not playing
as
much
as you want to play the Belcher on curve, you don't need it down this turn.
It's a much easier to play to make when you have the other execute in your hand.
Okay. And you're thinking about one thing on going into the Rat's turn 6 is Emperor, which he can't handle.
Yeah, exactly.
Although, if he swings, it might be difficult. Yeah,
you can still handle it.
Unless he like double interrages your Acolyte and plays Emperor, you're good.
Yeah.
The Rat still cannot lose life.
I'm not sure how good Commanding Shout is in this matchup. Oh, I'm interested to see what he does with it, I should say.
I wouldn't be surprised to see it as a cycle card at one point.
Do you think it's good enough to Emperor here? It doesn't really enable much.
Yeah, so you get just your Frothing, pretty much, because none of the other cards matter.
Yeah.
Slam can be
maybe
used.
An Execute. Yeah, but you don't really want to Slam on your combo turn anyways. And really, you want to hit the combo cards.
Well, Commanding Shout can do some hilarious stuff.
Actually,
sometimes.
Yeah, Commanding Shout is one of the combo cards, technically.
If he's not going to Emperor, then he really doesn't have too much else to do.
One thing I'm realizing is, like, on one hand, you kind of think the Rat is drawing some real garbage, but he kind of put all these cards in here. Like, Slam is kind of weird, and then Commanding Shout is there. So, I mean, you kind of have to draw them sometime.
He definitely has an idea for
these
cards.
Yeah, I mean, there has to be some strategy here. I mean, you have to be used to this situation.
Yeah, you can tell he wasn't that happy about the Emperor, but he felt like he had to do it or else he'd fall behind. He didn't. He needed to at least put the 5/5 on the board this turn.
Yeah.
He would. He prevents, like, Silentstorm's Emperor or Shield Maiden in this case.
After just seeing the execute, I mean, he's not even gonna... I think he's Death Spikes. Great way dealing with this.
Yeah, save the execute save for a turn when you can develop a creature.
Yeah.
Now, Nefarian is amazing in control matchups, especially control warrior, because most of your cards, you're getting like these heavy removal cards, like so execute, shield slam, and then things like crush, and then even like mortal strike can be removal. You get a ton of removal. I don't know how great it's going to be in this matchup, though, outside of brawl, which is another removal.
Oh, man. There it is. Commanding shout. God, Dread Corsair.
Oh, man. Yeah, he emperored it, like he was going to use it on his combo turn, but now, and then there's the whirlwind that he really wanted to hit with the emperor. It's rough.
I think the couple times I've seen Commanding Shout on ladder, it's always been used as a cycle card. Like, it's a good...
You have some really cool stuff you can do with it, though.
It's just... I mean, the rat's the best, so I'll trust his opinion on the card. But... Self-proclaimed best.
Well, we've yet to see him win, so...
Looks like he's just trying to set up for... He needs a draw, so he's trying to set up for a battle range here.
This is the first time he hasn't played Warlock in this tournament.
Okay.
So,
maybe. Soundstorm is getting low. We see he does have the shield main and the shield block, though. Just the one where the rat's like, if I just ROM him and hit him, he's almost dead. And no armor.
I think it's good enough, Harrison. I think actually Armorsmith too.
Yeah, that's a, is that the second death bite for the rat? Yeah, that's good enough, like you said.
It doesn't matter, it's just good enough anyway.
Yeah, yeah, you saw the Emperor come down here, and then you set up the death bite, so you want to prevent the big combo.
There is a piece, but...
Still trust you. God.
Yeah, so he can only draw two off Battle Rage. He casts both.
He's getting things in the wrong order for what he really wants to do.
If he Warsong, building Whirlwind.
Yeah, I guess.
And it looks like his first Warsong is going to go towards his Battle Rage turn anyways. And he has to kind of Battle Rage into a second Warsong.
Now, there's still not a Brawl in Silentstorm's hand, so if
I have to say, though, like, if the Rat's version of this Grim Patron Warrior plays that this way every time, it must actually be ridiculously hard to play.
Wow.
Soundstorm didn't even attack.
No, he didn't attack. He doesn't want him to get the draw of the two Battle Rages in his hand. That's hilarious.
Yeah, and he's not even playing the Dr. Boom because it can be kind of a liability with the Patrons. So he's just going for control. He's going to get the Nefarian down. And 8/8s are hard to deal with. They can execute one, and then usually they're out executes, and then you hit him in the face for 8. So if he has Alex in the deck, or Ysera.
I mean, even though...
You don't really want to play the Warsong Commander.
No. Silentstorm has such a feel for what's going on right now with how slow the Rat's played. Even though there's 8 cards in his hand, he knows that playing this way, like, he can't lose in this fashion.
Blood! I don't know, you can do a lot of damage with Frothing.
Well, absolutely. It is, but, like, it's just funny to see. Silentstorm's got a really good read on what's going on.
Funny thing is, all of this is because the Rat chose to armor up on turn 4.
Yeah. Unfortunately, Silentstorm can't even play as Nefarian, right? He only draws one card.
Does he draw any? No, he's at 10.
Oh, is he going to use the Neff? So he'll get a card in the spot that the Neff was. So yeah, he only gets one card.
Yeah, but then he mills himself the next one. He basically doesn't draw any.
Oh, that's true. And I think Brawl is all he cares about right now. Maybe an Execute.
He already used one. That's his last Execute.
No, I mean off the Nefarian.
Oh, yeah. I wonder...
Rooftar Ogre! BGH, yeah.
Good stuff. It's not really gonna hit anything else.
And it's nice because they can't patron into it. It's 4/2.
Yeah.
Pass me the
Rat's a little sad at how deep that gnomish was.
Yeah.
Guess it wasn't the second death bite, because that's the second death bite.
Yeah.
Look at that. Battle Rage doesn't completely suck.
It doesn't?
Not completely.
Oh, he's down to 29 finally?
Yeah.
Yeah, he can cycle it.
And he's going to get probably a decent death bite, I'd imagine. And it is the one mana one, so it doesn't need even more combos.
Absolutely. I wonder how many cards are left in the rat's hand, though. He's been cycling this whole game.
You mean in his deck?
Yeah.
No, he got his Acolyte executed, and then he just drew like one off that, and then two off the other.
Yeah, it's still probably 15-ish.
He's been trying to cycle. But nothing he's wanted at the same time.
Actually, I think Silentstorm's drawn more.
Yeah. Harrison, two Acolytes.
Yeah.
That's funny. Alright, so we can Neff. He has to use one of the one mana, yeah. I just want to see the Neff go down, but I don't think he's going to do it this turn.
What now? I don't think much is happening this turn.
Actually, no. Shield Slam is decent because it denies the Battle Rage draw. So we could Shield Slam, trade into the Armorsmith, and then Neff.
I'll trade Armorsmith first if you're doing that.
Alright. I know.
I still don't like Neff. I think I'd still rather just play something else.
Like Look, he's doing it in my order. Better. Okay, this is the first order of business before you draw. Huge miss.
Huge miss. I have no time for games. Why embarrass yourself like that?
So you know people are watching.
Alright, so he's making room for the Nefarian, looks like, with that fire equip. But like I would have liked to see the shield slam there. But maybe with no guaranteed way to proc execute outside of the fiery. If he wants to hold on to it, I don't know.
So I guess this is where you play out your hand and draw a lot of cards. This is what this deck's supposed to do, right?
Yeah.
Okay, well, let's see it.
Yeah, but the Sylvanas makes the Death's Bite Battle Rage awkward.
What now? No, it doesn't.
Do you have to... Do you do the three on the right? Do you patron?
You just...
Or you just do everything, okay.
You just don't kill Sylvanas.
Oh, you Death's Bite into the other one, okay.
Whatever he's doing, he's got to do it fast, because there's a lot of animations we got to go through before that rope is over.
I think you were talking about earlier, though, how when you don't kill a Sylvanas, you can get punished.
Yeah, but he's so far behind, I don't think he can...
Absolutely. He doesn't have the option, it's just...
This might be too slow.
Holding the... Oh, okay, you can't afford it.
The Battle Rage animation. Just to see if there's, I don't know what you could draw here.
Is there actually no cards that matter anyways? Maybe Inner Rage?
Yeah, I think that's the only one.
But I think he'd hold it anyways. He just wanted to draw, like you said. So would he have Inner
Rage? He's not happy.
He knows he loses to Brawl anyways.
I think Inner
Rage... But he would have pushed out an extra 5 damage, so...
Yeah.
But I think he's going to get that 5 damage no matter what, right? So I don't think it mattered.
What about just executing Sylvanas?
That's actually reasonable,
steals the Armorsmith.
Then you don't have to worry about as much about the Brawl?
Well, I mean, the Patrons still have charge if they come on your side. So, stealing one of those isn't even a bad idea.
Oh, no, he meant if the Rat executed Sylvanas, right?
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Well, I'm thinking about Silent Storm shield slamming. I think Silent Storm wants this Sylvanas to die.
Yeah, he's just thinking if he can afford the shield block to look for Brawl. Or just look for anything. Looks like it's not gonna display, yeah.
Nope. He wants to get rid of those things.
Yeah, he can. So it's good.
Keeps his Sylvanas just causing tension on the board.
I'm obviously the best Warrior player ever with my great ideas for Warrior.
Yeah.
It's one of my least played decks.
That's decent.
Yeah.
Alright.
Oh, three cards. Oh, okay.
Does he play Grom or no? Well, he has the commanding. Maybe he doesn't play Grom.
Well, he's got the Warsong Commander. And he has another Grim Patron in there. So Inner Rage. And we've only seen...
There's a second Warsong, though.
So. Okay.
So yeah, maybe a second
That is
Inner
the last
Rage.
Whirlwind. Yeah. Yeah, something might happen here. Maybe just develop a weapon and start pushing damage.
What now?
I don't know all the numbers of the thing. Like, if you play Grim Patron Warrior enough, it's like you just know the magic numbers of what happens if you have this. Yeah. It's like Combo Druid next level. Like, with Combo Druid, you know there's the 14, and there's the, well, if I can, let's play around 22.
Yeah. Yeah, if you've ever watched Razor stream, when he's play this, you know, he's played Warsong before Patron a lot, so he does the math like instantly.
Yeah.
He's like looks at it and knows.
Yeah.
That's a common theme on the player couch. Everyone instantly knows all these Patron players.
I feel like if you use Whirlwind, you can't actually win by doing damage, especially with three cards. So I like the face. I like just everything face.
That's what he does.
Good. I think he's still in this with that line of play. Maybe not. Two Belchers. It's a lot of animation time. Just put it that way. Even if he has an answer, it might not. It might not play through.
Nope. That's his hope. This animation. Wizard, please.
A duplicate Belcher might make a comeback as a Patron counter, because that takes even longer. You run it in, the secret pops.
Alright.
You take it farther and add no Stormo to that deck?
Yep, just throw it in there. There's more secrets. Spellbender.
Whoa! Okay.
So he can't what afford cards aren't the Warsong. In here? But yeah, he has a Patron for sure. Right? One more Patron.
I don't know, maybe just play one of.
Okay, sure.
Yeah, two commanding shouts.
This is the best Grim Patron Warrior in the world.
He only needs one.
Self-proclaimed.
But he can't Warsong and Frothing and Grim Patron on one turn, so I guess... But he has to Warsong with the Frothing pretty much no matter what, right? And then Patron just make a board and hope he doesn't have Brawl? Is that the plan? Or the other way around?
I mean, there's one win condition in his hand right now, and it's that Frothing.
Yeah, so it's never not going to be played without Warsong, then.
Absolutely.
Well, if the Frothing is the win condition, then you don't care that much about the Inner Rage. So I think you just Inner Rage Sylvanas, maybe? I don't know. You just let it hit you. Yeah, you let it hit you. Yeah. No, you can't Whirlwind. No, you can't let it hit you. You have to Inner Rage Sylvanas.
I must choose.
He's thinking Execute.
Oh, Execute.
That's a pretty good option.
But I feel like you can Execute the Belcher for more damage. More damage prevention.
Yeah.
Maybe not with a Grim Patron, but then you can't Grim Patron and Frothing. So if you execute that, then your plan is to win with Grim Patron. That's what that means, right?
I guess. Maybe he's hoping, like, maybe he makes a few Grim Patrons, and then maybe one of them sticks on his Warsong Frothing turn.
Well, what if he's got another Commanding Shout, and he draws that, and the card after that is Grim Patron, and Commanding Shout does work retroactively?
That'd be sick.
What now?
Be really nice. There's a lot that has to happen before that happens, though.
Is there? He hasn't got two cards. Basically, it's 50-50 if he has one.
Right.
Not that much.
If he plays two commanding, which is no way. That's the biggest obstacle. Strike. Yeah, I think it's the second Inner Rage.
Finally getting a Brawl would be nice.
Nope.
Yeah, that Mortal Strike is basically removal against this deck. Everything outside of the Emperor is dead to it.
It's double slam. That sucks.
Does he run Grom then? I mean, he has...
Oh yeah, it's Grom or cards. Another Grim
Patron.
No Grom.
It makes sense.
Well, here's where you need like a stealth spare part for your Warsong Commander.
Such a techie patron list. This is easily the most teched out list we've seen in this tournament so far.
Soundstorm's like 6 off lethal. I don't know if I'd say it's the most decked out. It doesn't have the BGH.
I mean,
it's got or the two owl. Slams,
like, I think it's decked out for its owl
strategy okay. So much is what I mean. Like,
I like to play like just crazy stuff. I like to just see what other people come up with. I don't think I've ever seen a double slam Grimpatient Warrior.
Yeah, that's the card people are cutting, I believe.
Yeah.
Yeah, so. But it's just in place of the Loot Hoarder, which some people play. Some people play one Loot Hoarder, one slam. Some people play two Loot Hoarders. Some people play two slams. That's not a great big deal.
What?
That's interesting.
Wasn't that the card he was supposed to win with?
I thought so.
Oh, okay.
He's gonna take it into fatigue.
Yeah, I didn't go to school for math, so.
Yeah, I'm here to cast, not to math.
Okay.
Yeah. The rat has some idea, I'm sure, how he's gonna kill Silentstorm. I don't see it.
I mean, that's 28 he has to go through. That's a big number. Yeah. That's like two digits, and they're not like that low of two digits. He doesn't even care.
No.
Like, that's six creatures. If the rat uses Whirlwind to combo anything, it gives him another six life above his 26. At least.
Yeah, that, I mean, I just don't think it's possible at this point.
Here's where we suck at math and he dies somehow.
Yeah, we're proven totally wrong. No, without Armorsmith, I don't think it's possible.
I don't think it's even close to possible.
I think it's Unstable Ghoul off the Shredder somehow.
Yeah, Shredder Shenanigans is the out.
Well then if Shredder Shenanigans is the out, don't you interrage the Shredder?
I mean, you're gonna be able to get to it, aren't you? With Patience?
Don't you need to get to it before that point?
I guess so. I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah.
Awesome.
I mean, that's it, though. That's really the only now. No, he's not... I don't know if the rat doesn't remember there's an Armorsmith over there, but...
He's gonna realize it pretty soon if he didn't.
Damn it.
Well... It is gonna be the ghoul that has to get that Shredder.
I mean, he runs Patron, and we saw a Zoo, so I know he likes to go phase. Maybe he just didn't see that Smith.
The second unstable goal. Oh, I guess he has time.
Well, everyone got in there. My favorite animation moment of the tournament, easily.
Yeah, I'm surprised. Yeah, Silentstorm didn't even need Brawl to win this matchup, which I thought was the pivotal card. The Harrison was pretty big, though. Okay.
Okay, well. I guess the rat's idea is that those things stay alive for, like, three turns.
Yeah, which, you know, is a valiant effort.
Mm-hmm.
It's an effort.
Well, if they both disconnect, Silentstorm didn't have anything on board, I guess we'll play it again.
I mean, you don't want to just quit. You don't want to be in there and just quit. So I like that the rat is pushing and trying to win this way.
Yeah, it's true. I mean, an asteroid could hit the local data center. There's a chance.
There's a chance. I'm a believer.
Yeah, just leaving the 1 HP patrons up.
Oh, man. The rat. He is still yet to win a game. I believe one player had lost five consecutive games earlier in the tournament as well. But
then they came back, yeah.
I think they won one before they started losing.
Yeah, well, you sound like you know. You look like you know what you're talking about, so I'll listen to you.
Yeah.
I trust you.
Yeah. I have freedom everywhere.
Hey, like in America Crypt.
America's okay.
Okay. You go to Venice Beach, you go to Muscle Beach?
No. I don't have time for that.
I imagine.
I'd sit here and talk about Hearthstone.
I imagine you and Life Coach together on Muscle Beach.
Yeah, if we just like stick real close together, we might just, you know, have the same width as like most of the guys there, probably.
Yeah. Okay. But you'd have more American pride than any of them.
That's true. That's true. Anyway, so what do you think of the rat? I mean, what can he do here? I mean, he seems to like sticking to a deck. In fact, the first switch he made in the whole tournament was with the Grim Patron. I guess he thought, maybe this Warlock deck's not going to win a game. Let's try Grim Patron because I know I can win with that.
And maybe then, that was just his long-term strategy. Like, he's like, oh, I'm going to pretend like, yeah, I always go to the same deck. And then once people think that's a pattern, then he switches it.
Yeah. Well, what can you do? I feel like Grim Patron is going to have to just do something. And if you're gonna go 0-6, you might as well do it with a deck you love.
I don't think the Rat will end up going 0-6. I think he puts up a fight here. He got here. That's not easy. And Silentstorm is amazing, but
Warrior time.
That's the kind of matchup.
I want to learn some more things.
Yeah, this so is kind of stuck with the Druid, which is weak against Patron. It's weak against Zoo, mm-hmm. and depending on the Hunter, it's like a slightly unfavored against Hunter, I'd say.
And this is gonna be like a ramp Druid with a million taunts, two oozes, and a Harrison, right?
Yeah, I imagine Silentstorm's gonna put some techs in for Patron, and
man, that looks pretty good.
Maybe Handlock. Who's that handsome
guy? These are actually the worst classes you've ever seen, by the way. All you see are like red dots.
That's all you need to say.
Oh. Okay.
Go driving later with those.
I don't drive. But I'll probably go in an accident walking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Silentstorm's looking pretty confident in the. Well, the rat's looking pretty discouraged. But like I said, those are three good matchups for him.
Yeah.
So you can easily see the reverse.
You have to keep in mind, this is the loser's match. I mean, if you win this, you still have to go through the other one and one-er, which is Phone Tap.
Yeah.
Which put up quite a fight against Life Coach.
He really impressed me, and I knew he would going in. This is probably the hardest group in the tournament for a reason.
I mean, but yeah, Phone Tap already beat Talonstorm, right?
Yeah. So. I'm really hoping the Rat can win a game, but I don't know how much faith I have. I don't know if I'm a believer.
Every three good matchups, he's good. He's good.
He'll win one.
It's true that he's played very well.
It's a great hand.
Just didn't really work out so far.
He hasn't done anything totally wrong.
The only thing people can really disagree with is armoring up on turn four.
Yeah.
And are we really disagreeing with that?
That's a hard one.
Yeah.
Argue.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. Wild Growth. That's pretty good.
That's nice.
Yeah, good card.
Where's that card?
It's a card that sucks. Most of the time, at least.
It's basically two mana draw.
Yeah, but when it's not, it's a highlight reel.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you gotta take risks to make those highlight reels. And I appreciate it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, for those who don't know, the combo of Warsong Commander, Grim Patron, Commanding Shout doesn't even need to get Emperored. Just magic happens where none of the patrons can die, and they just clear the entire board.
Yeah, but if you can sneak a Frothing in there, and you just wipe.
Okay.
When that happens, everyone gets in here and it's like really sparkly because they all get the cool Commanding Shout animation.
That's actually huge, the total denial of any Acolyte draws, yeah.
Yeah, from two cards guaranteed to zero. Millhouse? We haven't seen a ridiculous Piloted Treader yet. Piloted Treader.
Not today.
Not in the turn.
We saw Succubus earlier, it's pretty good.
Oh, I missed that one.
I want to get two attack creatures, a kind of a liability. There's no Patron in hand anyways, but it's not what you want. That's just the bad version of Minibot, basically.
Mm-hmm. Man, Talonstorm's gonna double shade. Or I guess he could Emperor, but that would surprise me. Mm. Well, I guess double shade has its own weakness.
Yeah, with the Death Bite right there, I think you just go with the double shade, rather than...
What about Druid the Claw now? I think Druid the Claw's the best play now. Because double shade has weakness to Whirlwind, Emperor has weakness to... Okay, you just don't play Emperor. But double shade has a weakness to Whirlwind.
Yeah. I mean, are you upset if the Rat...
I think you're upset if you go over.
You have no creatures left.
Yeah.
He's going for it.
You're forcing him to have both Whirlwinds, and then he's losing him.
I like Druid the Claw.
I like Druid the Claw the best.
Charge?
What feel nature's wrath?
I like taunt.
Alright, first.
Definitely taunt.
Is that Soundstorm or is that the Spectator, though?
No, that's Soundstorm.
Okay, nice.
I know. That's cool.
I guess the Emperor. Yeah, yeah, he clicked on it. Yep.
I think.
You Emperor because he's clicked on it.
Yeah, none of those cards matter, though, except for Force of Nature. Yeah, I don't think those... I mean, I guess he could do Jewel of the Claw plus one shade, and then he can stagger the shades.
Yeah, this is really bad, though. I mean, what's going to happen is he's going to use a Death Spite, but then drop his own Emperor, probably. No? Okay.
Yeah, so those are... He doesn't care about those cards getting...
Oh, I see.
Plus, he gets more Emperor cards now. Yeah, so there's the War Song.
Another War Song.
Yeah.
Okay, this kind of worked out for Soundstar. The Rat went with a bit of a greedy play.
His hand's looking really good for Emperor next turn, though.
Yeah. Yeah, Soundstorm really needs the Savage Roar, and then he'll be doing great. But without that, he's gonna have trouble.
Yeah. Just pushing, trying to set up a kill before he gets killed by the patron.
Well, a lot of combos are possible, but there's a long way to go.
Yeah, nothing that amazing. I think he wants to draw multiple off the Acolyte, and if he's going to use the Whirlwind, he kind of wants to hit something else, but there's nothing really that great.
I just like the Emperor.
Yeah, it's just, you saw your opponent
so good
put Druid Claw in charge, and he got two, he knows there's two cards that were Emperored in his hand. Is he scared of combo?
I mean, if you just Emperor, though, you're at 10 HP.
Yeah. Yeah, you're pretty dead. You're at 9, actually. Because, hero power.
Bring the pain. And it feels like he needs to hold on to the Whirlwind. By the power
of Ragnarok, okay. High risk plays.
Very.
Yeah, not getting defensive at all.
I'm hoping this pays off. Kind of.
Yeah.
That doesn't suck.
I wonder if Soundstorm will ignore it then.
I don't know about that.
I mean, all he needs to win is Savage Roar, so he could Wrath for one.
I think, yeah, I like the Wrath for one and just see what happens. I mean, with Druid, you're usually playing. Either a combination of cards or a plan to kill your opponent in a set number of turns, and just knowing what the next card is just changes up your gameplay most of the time. Or not. Or not at all.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I suppose you can Wrath for 3, hero power down, and then shade, and just...
That's actually pretty good. I like that. You don't need the Belcher right now. Belcher's always going to be good.
Yeah.
Unless he has a Death Spite on. But
yeah, this is the strongest play.
I like the attack for 3, though. Yep, good.
Yeah, definitely. Just need to push it and then keep it.
The Rat needs something, and it needs it soon, because there's a lot of cards that kill him.
We can get a Whirlwind Battle Rage turn off this turn, and he's going to get the Armorsmith, so... Yeah.
Another Whirlwind.
Yeah, okay, this will be pretty good.
Wait, can he win?
Is that
this turn?
Maybe?
Frothing Charge is 4.
He'll do the math.
He might.
Whirlwind. He can play another creature, then. He can do that with the Armorsmith, and with the Battle Rage. The Whirlwind kills most of those.
Looks like he's doing some long division on his paper there.
That's 6 creatures that get hit twice, so it's 12. No, it's not that lethal. It's fun, though.
It's very fun.
You gain a lot of armor, and you clear everything but the shade, which is the 3-3 one.
I think it's a play, for sure.
Yeah.
You could draw into inner rages, right? Can you afford the battle rage?
Yeah. Yes.
Oops, gonna come down in a second.
Yeah. Is this... We'll see what happens here.
We are all very good at math at this casting table.
think that's obvious by now.
It's not lethal, though, I don't think.
Yeah, this is full clear, and he's out of combo range, though.
Yeah. Last time he's like, okay. This game sometimes. That was awesome.
That was awesome.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Can't play it though. Next turn, one can dream.
You clear all this and hope your opponent's hand is commanding shout something that is good.
Well, it is commanding shout something that sucks.
Yep.
2-1 mana draw one.
That's exactly what Silentstorm wants.
Wow.
With both War Songs gone, and no ROM, he has no charges.
I think you Battle Rage. Oh no, you can wait to draw a creature in a Rage and then Battle Rage, I guess. Oh man. Well, at least that's up lethal if he doesn't have anything, but he has more than nothing. Let's just put it that way.
Yeah, the double taunt might just secure this. Probably does just secure this.
I think it does. Oh, I think he used the Innervate too.
Just heal up.
I mean, what else are you gonna do with it?
Yeah, it's the time.
I mean, if the only thing Innervate can do is maybe set you up with a more complicated playoff of draw card.
Just throw it out.
But if you get Ancient of Lore, I think you might heal.
Oh yeah, you're not. You don't need it right now, unless.
All right. So what's the rat looking for?
That's one of those
that
cards.
Asteroid on the.
Yeah, the asteroid. Asteroid. That's pretty good though. Not good enough, though.
I mean, that's probably one of the better draws in the deck right now, if not the best, but...
Not you're still going to be behind, though, so any one card is not going to bring you back, so maybe he needs to combo three cards together, then? No.
Yeah.
So he has to save those.
With Commander gone, though. Or both, the Warsong Commander's gone.
Yeah, but maybe he needs to make three patrons or something, so they can't be dealt with by the board.
Absolutely.
If Silentstorm draws any creature, though, he's dead in two turns.
I think Druid has creatures.
They have a lot of creatures. We just saw the Innervate get burned, so.
I'm just curious what he's thinking about. Like, he's got no Whirlwinds left.
Yeah, no, I think he's thinking, is there any. If I use these two cards now, can I win with any one card at a time?
Hmm.
He's like, maybe I can Gnomish into something. He's like. But I'm pretty sure he has to save. He has to go for a 3-card combo, but he knows he's dead in 2 turns pretty much, unless Townstorm gets swipe, maybe.
That's a good draw.
Really good draw.
This is where I'd be a bit salty if it was Arena.
Yeah.
You can just slam that, I'm pretty sure.
I mean, if a Frothing goes to a huge attack value. Big gaming, it's not really going to matter.
Yeah, but Warsong's down, so. Yeah, the double Warsong's down, so he knows just having it on the board is just as good as a removal as using it reactively.
This surprises me. It would set up lethal if he drove swipe. Or any other card that does damage for the most part.
Battle Rage, okay. That seems fine. Draw two cards. Two cards can be like execute.
Okay, so he needs with the mana. He can't patron now.
Why?
There's something specific he wanted.
What was that? We saw his deck.
Dread Corsair. I don't know.
What?
I think he needed two cards too.
I'm sure
but...
he had some sort of idea, but I can't think of what that card is.
What now?
No, and I feel for the rat. Like, again, he's in a situation where it's been grim a lot of this game.
I mean, he almost had it. I just feel like burning that second Warsong Commander kind of made it so it's very, very hard to push for damage from that point in the game.
I must choose.
Even this, like, damn, that sucks.
That looks.
Reptar Ogre!
I guess spell troops prep for our guy.
Yeah. 11, 12. Oh, you're good.
That's it.
Well, turns out the rat didn't win a game. That's a bummer.
It is a bummer. We know he's a good player. He worked really hard to come here and has proven how good of a player he is. It just didn't happen.
Silentstorm drops his first game, but wins the next. Gives him another chance. He's going to have to face Phone Tap.
Yeah, so he went 2-3 against Phone Tap the first time they faced up. So it's a really close series.
Really close series. Should be a pretty pretty epic set of games coming up. And the winner of that does advance to tomorrow's finals-ish. Final day.
Okay.
I don't know what they're calling it.
The grand final.
Grand final day. Whatever. Yeah. Pretty good stuff, though. At the very least, like he did go 0-6. But if you're gonna go 0-6, you're gonna show the world the craziness of what you know, which is Grim Patron Warrior, and it's pretty amusing to see. It's a deck where a lot of people try to play it because everyone says it's the most overpowered thing ever. But without seeing players who people know are good at it, it's hard to really make decisions. And I think in the very least, we've shown the public that armoring up can sometimes suck.
Yeah. He had the right idea first, and then he stopped. And then,
yeah.
There was some inconsistency with his ideas, for sure. But I don't think this is the last time any of us see the rat at a land like this.
Mm-hmm.
He's on one of the better new teams in Illuminati. I think this is, we'll see him again.
All right. Well, for now, we will see Silentstorm and Frodan. They're about to have a little chat and maybe get Silentstorm's take on that last match and maybe what he has to say about his opponent once again. Let's get to that.
Thank you very much, Crypt. That's right. I'm joined by Silentstorm, who survived elimination by going 3-0 against the Rat. That series looked like it was a pretty convincing win on from the viewer's perspective. How did it look from your point of view as you were walking through the series?
Yeah, I got the matchups I wanted for the first two games, and for the third game, I just had pretty good opening draw, almost died to a 22 Frothing Berserker though, but yeah, I had taunts to back me up in the late game.
You seem a lot more calm and composed. In first season, admittedly, you looked a little nervous just being able to play in front of the big stage. Do you feel a lot more calm this time around?
Just a little bit.
Still feeling a little nervous, I can get that. But overall, it seems like you're still on a good path here. Do you feel also a burden to perform because you're the Season 1 champion, and since then, we haven't heard too much about you ever since winning Season 1?
Yeah, definitely. People are going to expect a lot from me, but I'm afraid I won't make it through that deep.
So basically you're saying don't expect too much from you in case you don't want to disappoint them. That's perfectly understandable. But at the same time, people do have expectations, not only because of your performance in Season 1, but because of your new team. You're on Team Celestial, and being able to practice with some of those players is the best in the business. How have they been supporting you for this tournament? What's it like being on Team Celestial preparing for this tournament?
I didn't prepare that much. Preparing is for tryhards, I guess.
All right, well, I think that speaks volumes for how this has gone so far. But at the same time, you've been doing so well. So good luck in your next match, Silentstorm, and hopefully the RNG can be on your side. And with that, now we're going to go to our last match. We don't want to take too much of Silentstorm's time because we do have to get the runner-up spot, decide who is getting that final eighth place for tomorrow's round of eight playoffs. Let's go back to the desk and see what we have in store for our next match.